key joints. T-joints are intersections of two seams, or whenever there are three layers of membrane. All T-joints must be covered with a minimum 6-inch by 6-inch patch of uncured flashing tape. There are two types of T-joints on end laps, which we call upper and lower T-joints. The upper T-joint occurs on the upside slope of an end lap when the seams are shingled to shed water. The lower T-joint would be on the downslope side of an end lap. An upper T-joint is when the edge of the middle layer is exposed on the edge of the seam, while a lower T-joint has the edge of the middle layer hidden. T-joints will leak at the end of the middle layer, so it's important to understand upper and lower T-joints. T-joints must be made with uncured flashing tape. Some options would be minimum 6-inch by 6-inch patches with rounded corners cut from a roll in the field, 6-inch by 6-inch or 12-inch by 12-inch pre-cut T-joint patches, or pre-cut inside-outside corners. Do not use cured cover tape for T-joint patches. Apply tape primer with a Scotch-Brite pad in an area approximately 3 inches wider in all directions than the size of the patch being used. Tape primer should be dry, but remain tacky. Remove release liner and center the patch over the edge of the middle layer. The end of the middle layer on the lower T-joint will be buried under the membrane. The end of the middle layer on the upper T-joint will be the exposed edge of the membrane. Roll the patch with a 2-inch steel roller to ensure a proper bond. Be sure to roll along the edges of the underlying seam to ensure there are no gaps. Wait a minimum of 2 hours before applying lap sealant. Lap sealant should be applied to all edges of the T-patch. Things to remember. All T-joints must be patched. Only use uncured flashing tape as T-joint patches. Never use cured cover tape as a T-joint patch. Always use tape primer. Be sure to center the patch over the edge of the middle layer. Apply lap sealant on all edges of the T-joint.